Hi all, and welcome to episode 5 of the Beginner's Guide to FlightGear. Today, we're going to actually hop into the cockpit and get a hang of the controls. If you don't know what FlightGear is, take a look at the first episode. Now, a little briefing before we enter the simulator. We're going to be using the Cessna 172 for our series. It's not as exciting as a 787, but it's far easier to fly, and it's also used as a training aircraft in real life. Use whatever airport appears here. I'm using Phuket, by the way. Now, the most important thing, turn on auto coordination. I'm assuming you have it on, and if you have it off or will be using a joystick, there will be some differences. With all that covered, let's enter the simulator. Now, we're not going to be flying right now, because let's face it, you probably crash and die. So let's do something easier first, driving. Click Cessna 172P, then auto start to start the engines, and then drag the throttle in to 40%. Now hit tab to grab the yoke and steer the plane down the runway. The white dashed line indicates the center. Try to stay on that line by making small, precise adjustments. Remember, when you're actually flying, you'll be burying down the asphalt at 70 miles per hour, so you better drive it like a car on the highway. If you feel like you're going too fast, hit the B key to brake. If you're feeling gutsy, just add more gas. Soon after, you'll see an off-ramp which leads you to a taxiway. Follow the yellow lines onto the side road, again trying to stay on the line. This dial here is the speedometer, i.e. the airspeed indicator, marked in knots, about the same as miles per hour, and yes, it goes up to 160. See how fast you can go in an airplane now? Alright, so we arrive at the terminal, press 3 or page down to throttle down to the minimum, then shift B for the parking brake. Neat! You just completed your first trip in an airplane. Next time, we're going to finally take to the skies. Alright, thanks for watching this episode of the Beginner's Guide to FlightGear. We'll see you again next Saturday, or maybe next two Saturdays depending on my procrastination. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next time. Have a nice flight!